got some kind in the mail today. These nuts.
This week, I'm going to be upgrading the headliner in the F-150. Amplifiers produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, CT Sounds, and Extreme Autosports. I'm sound deadening the sheet metal behind the headliner, and I'm also stripping the gray cloth off this headliner and reupholstering it in black suede. Ford advertises this interior as all black. They missed a spot. What about the fucking top? This light gray headliner also shows a shit stain and a pin mark from that time I poked Rafa's mom's butthole with my fountain pen. I thought it was an inkwell. Turns out it was a stink well. Shot my pin out.
Jesus Christ.
I also have a water stain in the back corner of the headliner because it got wet when my window leaked from that other time that Rafa's dad put my truck together at the Ford plant in Mexico. Fucking missed a spot with the glue.
Shut the fuck up, Doug. Jesus Christ.
I picked up two types of suede. One is a luxury stretch headliner suede with foam backing, and the other is a felt-backed premium suede. Imitation suede. It's not real suede. Okay, it's not. I also picked up a gallon of spray grade upholstery glue and a fresh pair of Wiss upholstery shears for Rafa's mom's gorilla mane trimming appointment later.
Doug, right now it's not time for this.
I nicknamed these my piss scissors because Rafa's mom's gorilla's mane is on her pussy. Liable to get piss on my whiz.
Are you done so you can shut the fuck up, fucking sorry ass bitch?
To remove the headliner, I must first carefully dismantle the A pillar, the B pillar, and maybe the C pillar. But I shouldn't have to touch the D pillar, which is my dick. The D pillar. I also need to remove my visors and the dome lights. The dome lights are so Rafa's mom can see while she's gorking my D-pillar.
The dome light.
I'll need to reupholster these visors with the felt-back suede and paint the small gray pieces with the matching SEM interior paint.
What the fuck?
Now look what you guys did. Now I broke the screw cover off my garment hook. How am I supposed to hang my jacket back there now? My suit.
Familiar faces.
For my court date. Yeah. If this was your car, it wouldn't be a big deal. I would just stick it back on with some butyl. Do you know what butyl is? I call it gorilla snot. I'd monkey snot it back on. You would never notice. But this is my car we're talking about.
Bright and early for the day.
Now I'll have to go to the Ford dealer and buy a new hook. You have to be careful on this side because there's side curtain airbags. So if one wrong move, you deploy the airbag. To get the headliner out, I need to take the B-pillar off. But to take the B-pillar off, I must first take the step panels off. And then the seat belt. Like some sort of overlapping puzzle. Damn. If I want to replace my glove box door, I have to start by taking the right rear tire off to access the glove box pin. And then grind the welds off my intake manifold. Take the cover off, then I can take... I have the headliner dropped, now I need to get it out. This is the Bluetooth mic for my Pioneer deck. I never ran the Sony one yet, so we could probably replace that. My choices are to gently taco the headliner and coax it out of the truck without creasing the fuck out of it. Or I could take my entire interior out and the floor off so I can get it. This thing's big as fuck. Or my last choice is I could reupholster the headliner inside the truck and spray glue all over the fucking. tacoed the bitch. It's out.
You're rewrapping anyway.
So my back window was leaking, so there was water getting into my headliner at one point.
So we got some water stains. Here's Rafa's mom's butt stain.
Not to be confused with Rafa's butt stain, which is his Mustang. Mustang with a broken leg.
I snapped my knee, man!
Oh, no.
I broke my knee, man!
Fuck yourself.
911, dude.
Now is the point where I would just spray over the old material, wrap the suede over the old headliner material, slap it back in, charge you extra for rush delivery, and send you on your way if this was your truck. But this is my truck we're talking about here. So for the best outcome, I'm going to painstakingly strip all the old material and foam off the headliner before reupholstering it. To remove all the old foam, I'm using a wire brush. I should have left it. Fuck. Now I can't go back. Once all the old foam is stripped off the headliner and everything's cleaned up, we'll be ready to rewrap it in the luxurious, foam-backed, stretch imitation suede, which is especially designed to repel ass stains while simultaneously attracting pussy stains, because that's how luxurious it is. It's just... Most automotive interior suede upholstery is synthetic suede. How big of a cow's ass would you need for a fucking headliner? His mom's cow?
Yeah. It's not the time for this.
Does Rafa have a cow?
Doug.
This headliner is stripped of its foam. It's all cleaned up and ready to reupholster. Next time, I'll sound deaden the sheet metal and we'll start wrapping the headliner with foam-backed luxury stretch headliner suede upholstery material. Thank you guys so much for always watching. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think about today's episode. I'll see you guys next time. Support Amplified by buying iPad dash kits and Soundman merch at soundmanca.com. Become a car audio master with the tools and trainings available for mobile solutions at mobilesolutions-usa.com. Receive a discount on all the best car audio equipment from CT Sounds by using coupon code SOUNDMAN at ctsounds.com. And come down to see me and Rafa at Extreme Auto Sports in Santa Clarita and get great deals on audio and performance equipment and installation.